I'm Nikku Madhusudhan. I'm a professor of astrophysics and exoplanetary science at the Institute of Astronomy, University of Cambridge. I work in exoplanets. I'm mostly interested in understanding the atmospheres of these planets and more recently on Hycean worlds in the search for habitability and life elsewhere. A Hycean world is a theoretical construct we came up with a few years ago. It's basically a planet with ocean-covered surfaces and underneath a hydrogen-rich atmosphere. The idea is that the surface and the pressure and temperature at the surface of the ocean underneath the atmosphere would be not too dissimilar from what we see in Earth's oceans, which are conducive for life. So this planet, K2-18b, is roughly 2.5 times the size of Earth and about 8.5 times the mass of the Earth. This is significantly bigger than the Earth, but we have in the past suggested that this planet could be a candidate Hycean world. And in our present study, what we found is indeed a hydrogen-rich atmosphere and copious amounts of methane and carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. We also did not find ammonia, so we would expect ammonia along with methane if it were a deep hydrogen-rich atmosphere like Neptune or Uranus in the solar system. So the non-detection of ammonia and the detection of methane and CO2, we find that the only way to explain that composition is if we had an ocean underneath the hydrogen-rich atmosphere in this planet. And that is what takes us one step closer to potentially finding that this planet is a Hycean world. We need more observations to confirm this, but that's the current interpretation. So we have also found a very tentative hint of dimethyl sulfide in the atmosphere. Now we call it tentative because we are not very confident about it, and it is possible that with future observations that signal might go away, or there could be some other molecule that we may not have considered. But if it is confirmed in the future with future observations and theoretical work, then that has major implications to our understanding of planetary habitability. There are two possibilities. One is that, for example, on Earth, DMS is produced only by life. There is no other way process that is known to produce DMS. So if that were true on this planet as well, then that could potentially be indicative of some biological activity in this planet. On the other hand, there may be other processes elsewhere in the universe, especially on planets like this, that we don't yet know about that can produce DMS without life, in other words, abiotically. Either way, it is going to be a major breakthrough. You either find a new process in planetary science that can produce DMS that we do not know of yet, so it'll be a new abiotic process, or we find some evidence of biological activity. Either of these would be a major breakthrough for science going forward.